Stab Hal Ashed. Not Elohat, Sophok Awon, Ama Elohat, Isent Lam Haluk, Awa Mahuthum, Bahoy Ilaint. Inanuk Halana Shil, Hamma Forabi Pashil, Deunas, Asa Turkeli, Wa in Ye, Madunas Deru, Rusile, Na Panas Dor, Aferti, Atumre, Karn Wapulia Kaso, Parakoi Shils, Alumani, Fanuk Arsilu, Istazga, Ela Rasula Tukatumre,
Father Divine right there, and to the right you can see he has buses, he had mansions, he had everything, and guess what? They called him God. While no one knows where the money comes from Father Divine's strange new religious cult flourishes and feeds thousands, the center photo shows Father Divine, diminutive Negro, who has attracted a tremendous following with heavens. And so it wasn't churches or temples, it was heavens that they were called, situated throughout the country. Above left is the heaven in Seattle, Washington, and the bus that he has as well. So that's a heaven right there. Instead of churches, this Negro's buying mansions and telling you, okay, now we got heavens. So that's him. And he also, now, don't get me wrong, he was a smart businessman.
One of the most singular, enigmatic, and polarizing characters in this city's story is Father Divine, leader of the International Peace Mission Movement. To many, he was just a rabble-rousing preacher, a nuisance who manipulated his way to power and wealth. To his countless followers, though, he was and is God incarnate. Father Divine began accumulating disciples in 1919 after buying a home in Sayville, Long Island. The practical bent of his preaching and his intense charisma soon attracted curious pilgrims from as far as the West Indies and Europe. At its zenith in the 1930s, Divine's peace mission movement exceeded 2 million followers, with hundreds of outposts across the United States and as far-flung as Australia and Switzerland. Followers championed racial integration at a time when segregation was the law, and practiced celibacy, teetotalism, and modesty, while the rest of the country was recovering from the Roaring Twenties. They practiced a form of small-scale communism, but called their religion Americanism. They even accepted Father Divine seeming to violate his own commandments by taking two wives in his lifetime, both known as Mother Divine. Uniquely enigmatic for an international faith leader, Father Divine's origins remain a mystery. No birth certificates or records exist from before he chose to make himself known as Reverend Major Jealous Divine at that house in Sayville. One of the most puzzling elements of Father Divine's story was his wealth. Remarkably, he had managed to become the first black landowner in Sayville. Yet when the boisterous prayer of his disciples and the irritability of his white neighbors prompted an investigation by the district attorney's office, investigators found that Divine collected no money from followers to support the expanding movement.
Not and do not and will not receive compensation, remuneration, love offerings, donations, or anything of that sort for my spiritual work and activities from any individual. I'm a free gift to the world, gratis to mankind.
By the mid-30s, while many Americans could hardly afford to feed their families, Divine was being chauffeured from mansion to mansion in a private limousine. Peace Mission members ate massive weekly banquets and bought hundreds of properties for the church's use. The source of this seemingly miraculous financial bounty has never been fully resolved, but a great portion seemed to come from followers tying their businesses to the movement's coffers, keeping only a fraction of their profits for themselves. This system allowed the movement to provide plentifully for all of its disciples. Many of the most dedicated lived in self-sufficient communal enclaves, where Divine's strict moral code was law. Even now, 50 years after Father Divine, in the language of the movement, laid his body down, a few enclaves exist, populated by individuals who remain faithful to him in every way. What was it that allowed Father Divine to command such unprecedented devotion?
Is get an asset to be secured as interest. The bank is allowed to create and lend as much as debt as they want, as long as they do not exceed a 10-to-1 ratio imposed by the Fed. And you're like, what the hell does that mean? Just focus on the asset, factor, make money asset, offset asset, sits on the throne, get your assets, get your offset. Put that black woman back on her throne. That's what asset means. Yeah. And where's that throne at? In her house. That's where she raises God.
How much for the pizza, bro?
For you,
$15.
Whoa. That's a hell of a notch you got there, Tommy. What'd you get?
Oh, come on, man. You know how I do. Here you go, bro. You keep the change.
You know, man, you cool, but we go back like spinal cords and car seats. But your man right here got a bad attitude, Chief. Here, enjoy your day.
Now the trick is, how do I get the house without spending any real money? So I can turn the house in and get back money. So I can become free and do my thing. So I can stop driving around with the diplomatic plates on my car. That sounds like a motorcycle.
All right, so if you're interested in a trust, or you're interested in the mentorship, or you're interested in consulting, just go to brother, polight45@gmail.com. I want to thank y'all very much for the time and the opportunity that you gave me to share information. I hope it's empowered you, and I hope you use it to empower other people. I hope you follow up. I hope you go get the corresponding books. You know I've written over 90-plus books, and I got some new ones that's a doozy, but I got many economical books. Make sure you email bp@iambrotherpolight.com. BP, as in Brother Polight. Those two initials, bp@iambrotherpolight.com, if you're interested in any promotional codes, discounts, or rebates. Peace to the family. I love you all. Again, put your full name and your phone number on anything that you send. Your full name and your phone number on anything that you send. Thanks a lot, people. You are...
Feet on the dirt, get in tune with the planet.
Carbonation TV.
So everybody that come there, they gotta go through you first.
What you mean?
So it's your world, so they gotta go through you first. Then
not at all. Why would you say that? Like, if somebody came for Tron and that's my bro, even in, like, if that's my bro and they came for Tron or they came for Nubian, what you mean? Like, Nubian had another girl here. It was a white girl. Like, you feel what I'm saying? He had plenty of wives here. How many wives have I even gave you? I gave him like 3-4 wives before, dog. I'm not bent like that. It's not how I'm built. I'm not built to be like greedy. I'm not a greedy person, man.
He looks like a broke-ass sexual chocolate.
And with that being said, have a beautiful night. Donation link is in the description. I love y'all. Peace.
Peace, peace, family. Welcome to YoungFrail.net. Subscribe now for exclusive access to me and all of my content for things such as lectures, Frail Ally Universities, children's videos, radio interviews, behind the scenes and documentaries, and much, much more. Be sure to subscribe now, family. Also, don't forget the internet YouTube promo code, which is YouTubeYP. Internet for a discount off your subscription. So with that being said, family, you get exclusive access to me and all my work. And as I continue to grow, I want y'all to grow with me. So with that being said, family, YoungFrail.net, subscribe now. Also, follow me on social media, family. Instagram at Frail_Ally. Twitter at Frail_Ally. Facebook at YoungFrail. And subscribe now to my YouTube channel at YoungFrail. And with that being said, family, I'll see y'all in the classroom. Peace.
Gonna be my take on Young Pharaoh situation. I made a couple of videos about him. Whether he's a con man, is he a righteous man that he claim he is? He ain't none of that. Young Pharaoh don't care nothing about none of his subscribers or his followers. Half of them don't know what he's talking about, no way. That's right. All of a sudden, we savages now, Young Pharaoh. Oh!